It looks rather unassuming at the moment, but in 11 days' time, this belfry will be fit for a queen. With flags, bunting and banners, the belfry barge will herald the start of the pageant and will be the only music barge requiring no amplification.
I think it's going to be loud. Some concerns that it might be too loud. But we'll go down the at the front of the procession. We're the first boat down. So there's 1,000 boats behind us. And this barge is being pushed by a tug.
The company behind Big Ben cast the bells, each named after a senior member of the royal family. Last week, Prince Charles visited the Whitechapel Bell Foundry, which opened in the 1500s, when Elizabeth I was queen. Moving the finished belfry is heavy work. It weighs more than 10 tonnes. It will lead the largest celebration to be staged on the Thames for more than 300 years, and it's essential that navigation and timings are accurate.
Our biggest problem bridge is Westminster, because we have to get under 5.5 metres on the day, working to a specific tide. So that's been one of the sort of the main challenges, to ensure that we can get the barge sunk to the right level in the water, and then that the structure is the right height to clear.
Well, now that the belfry is safely on the barge, the team are just working to secure it. And on the day itself, there'll be 8 bell ringers working deep down in the barge, so unfortunately they won't get much of a view. This is the sound of the Charles bell. With the other 7 pealing, more than 105 decibels will be ringing out to an estimated worldwide audience of 1 billion. Claudia Sabazis, BBC Southeast Today, Gravesend.